I'm going to do your makeup and show you how to do the perfect winged eyeliner, as well as doing some very nice eye makeup on you. Something somewhat simplistic, but also very elegant. I've had a lot of recent practice with, well, not just recent, for a long time, with the winged eyeliner, so I'm going to show you how I do that, and then I'm going to do it on you. I haven't finished up my makeup entirely, so I'm going to do that real quick. I got my foundation, I got my concealer on, but I just got a gift from my mom early this year. She is an Avon representative, and she caught wind that I'm going through a makeup experimentation phase, so I think today I'm going very purple, dark lipstick. It's really, really dark. And trying out a couple of new things as well. So I still have my hair in rollers. I'm trying to make my hair kind of poofy for my next recording session. But I didn't finish my makeup because one thing I'd like to try on both of us is a new blush. And this is actually part of a bronzer palette, which I'm way too pale to use, but look at how nice and pretty that blush is. Yep, that I'm going to be using, and possibly also the bronzer as in eyeshadow. And then this adorable little palette here, and it's got some very nice earthy tones. So let us do your eye makeup, and then we can do the perfect wing for my wings. I use one of two eyeliners typically. Let's see if I can find them here. I think my favorite is this e.l.f. liquid eyeliner, and it's about $3 at Walmart. I usually don't purchase name brand makeup or really expensive makeup. I can't really afford much high-end makeup. But enough about me. Let's focus on you. I am going to take a little bit of eyeshadow primer, if I can find it. I'm going to dab this on your eyes so that your eyes a bit sticky. That just kind of holds it in place. Somewhat liquidy. Just gonna move it up to the brow bone a little bit. It's starting to get tacky. That's what we want, though. Alright. I was thinking about using a cream eyeshadow, but I really want to play with this. And I'm going to use a somewhat flat brush. I'm flat poofy brush. I'm going to start with the most skin tone color, and it's a semi-shimmer. It's not really pronounced, but I'm just going to... We have a beautiful sunset here. It's nice and orange outside. Now with the wing, what I want to do is create a slant that goes up to the very tip of my eyebrow. And so everyone that does something very similar might have a slightly different look to their wing. But most will go from the corner of your eye up to the very tail end of your brow. I'm only going to do one eye at a time now. And something else I've learned is that by adding it will allow the blending to be a lot smoother. Just my observations. I'm gonna do your other eye. Right to the tail end of your brow. More to pack that on there. Okay. Gotta wipe that brush off on my pants here. And I don't know if I want to be risky today or if I want to go something a little bit more natural. But I think I'm going to take this brown matte color. I think I'm going to go more natural. Using the very same brush. Pack that on the lid and drag that out towards the corner of the eyebrow. I'm going to take a little bit, so I'm going to take a, I forget what this brush is called, kabuki brush. Or a foundation brush, and just kind of push that back, so that any of the fallout that happens right here on the corner and bring it out to the tail end of your eyebrow. That's where we're at. And now I'm using a blending brush. And this looks a little bit stained, but it's clean. I'm gonna take a little bit of that gold. Give it a little bit more of a brightness. Because it's also a blending brush, you can kind of blend it around a little bit. Maybe I want something that I can stamp it a little bit better. I think this is probably my favorite brush, especially when you're doing something that you want to do quickly, because it, for me, it stamps on the color really quickly. You can also use it to blend quite a bit. Alrighty. Going to be for the inner corner here. I'm going to use this nice little light shimmer, and this is going to make the inside of the eye pop a little bit. So I'm going to use a very small brush and just pop it in there. Same on you. On the inside. Yeah, it doesn't take that much. Very nice. Okay, I'm gonna take that brush and just kind of pull away any of the excess. Another thing that I sometimes will do is I'll take a regular pressed powder compact and start to really get low on it. I'll just use a little bit and sweep it away. Like that. I'm not going to do this side just yet. The wing. This is just how I do mine, but I try to look into the mirror and keep my eyes as relaxed as possible when I make the first line. So I start by just looking straight forward, making a dot where I want it to end. So today we're gonna do it right there. Along the top side of where your eyelashes meet your skin. That's a little bit difficult, is forcing yourself not to blink. But you can do it. Alright, let me get you some nice little wings. I want you to just maybe look away, but keep your eyes very natural and relaxed. Stay okay. Blink and just know I'm going to touch your eyes, so try to be relaxed. Try not to blink, okay? Right, here we go. It's cold and it's wet, but it'll dry. But I've tried a lot of different eyeliners over the last year or two, and I really like the liquid ones because it makes moving the actual makeup across the eyelid so much easier than when they're like dry, or if the brush is really stiff, it hurts and it feels like I'm stabbing myself in the eye. And this has a very soft felt brush. It's very, very precise, and it's very liquidy. Okay, so we're gonna put that first starting point right there. Okay, go ahead and blink and get ready. I'm gonna just drag this along the top of your eyelashes. Really, just I'm gonna make mine just a little pointier. I'll do the same for you. Just a little pointier. Go ahead and blink and get ready. Nice. That's gonna take just why don't we put on a little bit of blush? I've been dying to try this blush. I'm gonna take my big fluffy brush. Oh my, that's really... that's a lot of pigment. Buff that out a little bit with some pressed powder. That is so bright and vibrant. I like it. But was much more successful than mine. Much for contour. Try just a little bit. Okay. Well, now that that is set, let's try a new mascara. It's been a long time since I've switched mascaras. And this is the Super Extend by Avon. In a way, that's good, I suppose. I really like that that's so thick. My wing. And it looks good on you as well. But I think that the secret, it's not really a secret, to doing any kind of wing, or at least my technique, is to look head on in the mirror, keep your eyes as relaxed or in their most natural state, put a dot, and that little dot is where the end of the tail will be, and it usually will line up with the tail end of your eyebrow. And then from there, I usually just drag inward and go over the very thin line between, well, right on top of where my eyelashes meet my skin. Are we feeling adventurous today? And this is called Purple Peace. That is purple. For a swatch. It's very creamy though. Here goes nothing. Why don't we use something that's more like a mauve? It's one of the tricky things about using really dark lipstick is it can quickly go everywhere. How about more of a matte mauve? Okay. Just open up your mouth and relax. relax your lips. A little bit of a touch up on those wings just to make sure that all the lines are nice and sharp, okay? Just gonna trace my lines a little bit, make them nice and dark. Go to blink and get ready for it. Now here's something I'm gonna try. I might regret it, but this is a cream blush called Blushing Nude, and I'm not gonna use it as blush, but I'm gonna use it as a lipstick. I'm not so sure it's good for that. But it would probably go good with a liner. This is what I had on yesterday, and this one is called Bold Bordeaux. I'm not saying that correctly, but this is a nice wine color. I'm just gonna put it over it. Now I can finish up my other eye, and those are the techniques that I use.